Okay, I'm going to summarize this kind of right up front for everybody here. Octavia's abilities are obviously all based around her music, and music is meant to be fluid. Kind of like that famous quote from Bruce Lee about being water.
Empty your mind, be formless, shapeless, like water. Water can flow, or it can cry. Empty your...
The same applies here. Case in point, do you notice anything interesting going on here? I'll give you a hint. Those buffs are not dropping, and I'm not stopping to refresh them. Sure, as you can see, my melody is pretty complicated, which means I've got to time a lot of crouches and melee hits in there to keep those buffs up, but I'm not stopping to spam it, I'm fluidly working that into my playstyle. I'm actively listening to the music and acting along with it. Kind of like dancing.
I am one with the music.
That's a big part of why I love Octavia so much, is because a 30-minute mission turns into a 30-minute dance party. And by that, I'm not talking about the dance emotes or her idol animation. I'm talking about the fact that moving and acting with the music, just like a dance, has a really big impact on her viability. Now, this doesn't mean that your songs have to be really complicated. In fact, you can get the same results with a really simple song. You know what? Let me give you guys a first-hand example. Let's go to the simulacrum. Okay, we're in the simulacrum. First up, I'm gonna be playing with a pretty simple song. This is just a really quick cover I made of Sail by AWOL Nation, and you can see that it's pretty sparse. Now, most people, when playing Octavia, are stopping to refresh their buffs. They'll play their mission, and then every so often, they'll stop to refresh their buffs. Now, if your song is pretty simple, pretty sparse, you only have to crouch twice to refresh your stealth. So what a lot of people have been doing when trying to min-max their song is to put as few notes in the melody as possible so that they can refresh their buffs with minimal interruption to the rest of their gameplay. Overall, I'd say that this is not a bad tactic at all. It definitely works. I'd say that it's the best way to min-max a song for those that are not really musically inclined or who prefer a more laid-back playstyle. But personally, my favorite mechanics are those that reward very active, skillful play with a rewarding gameplay experience. So since I enjoy really active gameplay, I've written a song that's very active to go along with it. And while playing, I'm constantly kind of crouching and meleeing along with the beat. If we do this without metronome, it kind of looks like this. And before you ask, you can get a really similar result with slide attack macros, but I wouldn't suggest it because if you miss the beat, it can be a lot more difficult to recuperate from that and readjust your gameplay to get back to beat. And also, if you have a macro that you hold down to continuously slide attack, you can time it to the beat, but differences in terrain and cold procs and everything like that make it really, really, really easy to fall out of beat. Before we get into it here, this is my build. After my vitality, my stat priority is power range first, then power duration, then efficiency. I didn't max my duration because if you're dancing with the music, you typically don't need it. If you're continuously kind of dancing with the music, then your buff is refreshing every couple of seconds. So any extra duration is basically just a cushion and it's just there for cast efficiency. And you'll notice I pretty much dumped power strength because in most cases, I'm not really using her abilities for the damage because in general, avoiding bombard rockets is more important than seeing high damage numbers. Also, you'll notice that I've got Cunning Drift and Maglev in there because since I'm kind of crouching and sliding so much, this actually makes for a pretty great quality of life improvement. It really kind of helps keep the constant crouching and sliding from being a hinder on my mobility. Now, as we all know, the bass section in Octavia's songs doesn't really make a difference in terms of your damage or your buffs or anything like that. And from what I've been able to tell with my playtesting, the percussion section doesn't really make that much of a difference in terms of DPS, unless you're using it without rollerball, in which case a sparse percussion section theoretically can do a little more DPS in low-level missions because it allows the enemies to attack your mallets just that little bit more, giving it a little bit extra damage. In high-level missions or on low-strength builds, the enemies can typically survive long enough to get in a few hits, so functionally it doesn't make that much of a difference. And as far as group play goes, if you're trying to buff your teammates, I've seen a lot of conflicting opinions out there. I know a lot of people say that they prefer slower songs, but functionally, I've only ever seen people successfully stealth to my metronome with a more complicated song. For now, I'd say that your best course of action if you're in an organized comp is just to talk to the rest of your squad before you start the mission to ask them which they would prefer. If you're running with randoms, I'd say that your best bet is to maximize your personal impact on the mission rather than trying to write a song to placate everybody. To summarize, I'd say that playstyle is king, more so with Octavia than with most of the other frames. But that's it. I know I've said it before, but I am absolutely loving Octavia. She's my new favorite frame, which is a really big deal because Xcal has been my favorite from the start, and she just kind of bumped him right out of there.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. Because a vision softly creeping.
But I hope this has been helpful. I hope this results in a little more constructive conversation about her songs and how to min-max them. So, my name's JoeyZero. Okay, bye. Oh, also, in retrospect, I haven't been super clear about the fact that I have a Twitter. So, yeah, do it. Twitter, go. Link in the description. Go. Go do it.